Hi guys, Stephanie Hale here. We're going to talk about ezinearticles.com today. It's an article submission site that's blowing everyone else out of the water. Brilliant. You can, once you get to ezinearticles.com, you can search in the top Google search bar by author's name or topic, or you can click on a topic below and just see what articles are available to read in that topic. It's really cool. The featured authors are there. They just randomly feature authors, so you will be up there eventually. The recently approved articles are on the front page listed there, and they schedule out, you know, as they add new ones. There's a blog and a forum, which is brilliant, and you should definitely check those two things out when you sign up. Okay, we're going to talk about signing up, actually, to get your bio and everything ready. Okay, so you click on the top thing there, submit articles, and that's where you'll get this. If you're already a member, then you just log in, okay? But then you'll fill out all of the things that they need, your name and address and phone number and your business URL or personal URL, and create my account. Make sure you check the two boxes to get the email series because they're brilliant information. You're taken right to your submission area where you would submit an article, okay? And you choose the category, the article title. Notice with the keywords to only space them with a comma, not a space too. Like, because you only get so many characters, 100. And you don't want to waste your characters. It shows you an example right by the keywords area. Okay, and the characters left, it tells you how many you have left on every single different box, your title, your keywords, the little red buttons right there. Those will give you an audio for instructions. Oh my gosh, this is brilliant. You should listen to all of the instructions so that you make sure that you get it right. You click yes, I agree, spell check, and always preview your article first. It'll show you what's misspelled and that sort of thing. And then be sure to read the author agreement, always. And then submit your article. Or you can save changes for a draft if you'd rather. But if it's ready to go, go ahead and submit it. Under Profile Manager, it's going to show you additional available author. You can have an additional author, or you can change your name, like if you get married. Your author resource boxes. There's going to be three choices. I know I said four, but the fourth one is actually your main bio area. These are the three. I just change up my URLs, usually with the first two, and then make the third one shorter. And then when you click save, you'll get the little blue box that says your save, you know, your thing is updated, your resources are updated. And you choose your author name to add a photo. When you click under Profile Manager to add a photo, you just click again on your name and you'll come here. And then you click the Browse tab, just like everywhere where you add a photo. And you'll look in your computer file under Pictures, and whichever one you want, you highlight and you click Open. And then there it'll be, your URL will be there, and upload photo. That's it. And it also gives you an area to upload 30 professional photos as well. Take a peek in on your author's area home page right, you know, early, and it'll tell you, there's a little bar there that'll tell you how far along you are. This is your main author bio, okay, under Profile Manager. This is going to be longer. You're going to have more URL areas, your blog area, and your bio, your big bio. This is sort of a medium-sized one because you can do one even bigger than this, too. And now we're going to look at my author's home area because mine's already done. I have articles over above my picture. I can get my stats. The account status under Article Manager is going to show you where you are, how many submissions you need to go to the next level. And then under Category Rankings, they actually rank your article through all of the articles on that topic and tell you how high up you go. I do best on, of course, blogs and social networks and video games and gaming. And a couple of articles on MLM, which is cool. I did really well on those. Out of, you know, however many, out of 1,500, I ranked 134. So that was pretty good. This area is your, it displays all of your articles and how many clicks you've gotten from the links, how many views to your article. Now, some articles are going to do better than others, and you can't guess. You cannot second guess that. You don't know. Submit them all. Because the ones I thought that would not do as well are my first and second highest ranked articles. Okay, and this is the page everyone else is going to see when they come see you as an author at eZine Articles. Then they can click on your extended bio and go see all of this information. All of your articles are going to be listed there and an extended bio of you. All right, well, enjoy, and I'll get back with you guys.